drain another adjoining piece of property.
And so you're just...
You can go from, because you notice how it went out horizontally?
Yeah.
That horizontal can go out as far as a mile, if not more. So you can go from this piece of property, go across the road. I don't really know how, I don't know this land very well.
You can go under
this,
someone's property without a lease?
Yes, you can. You technically can. I don't know how we're gonna resolve that issue. I haven't looked too much into it myself. I've been worked, I think more seriously, it's just, we don't really need the natural gas, because as Mano was mentioning, we can get rid of it, the need for it, through efficiencies and through other methods of production.
Let's stop
this. There are many I can give you a list of organizations that are actually working to stop it, and afterwards I'd be more than happy to give you names of organizations. There's a strong coalition of organizations right now working on this.
I'm just wondering if people don't want to do it, if they can do it through eminent domain.
I don't think they can. I'm not sure about that.
Who's the
eminent? These are private companies that are coming in, and I know, yeah, it's, I don't really know how to answer that question, though.
It seems to me that the gas might, if some genius lawyer would start working on this, you could make the gas the same sort of thing as air rights. I let planes fly over my property all the time, but... And I own that airspace theoretically. And why don't we all own the gas if somebody's going to drill? We ought to be all getting some benefit from it.
The way New York State law is set up, as far as your land goes, you as the property owner own what's underneath you. As some people unfortunately find out when they buy a house or a piece of commercial real estate, and later find some kind of an old oil tank or something that's polluting the ground.
No, I mean,
they become responsible for that tank.
A couple of hundred feet down, yeah. But how about 1,000 feet down?
I don't know if there's anyone ever put a limit on it, but as of right now, you need to get the property owners right and pay the property owner to extract the gas.
And
except in that special circumstance where I was mentioning, when you get a certain percentage of the area around it, then they can... But in that situation, I should back up, that person who says no still gets royalties sent to them. They get their fair share for whatever it's worth. But of course, they have to deal with a lot of the bad parts of gas drilling. I've only scratched the surface and undersurface, I guess, of what I'm saying of this. I knew you had another question.
Has some genius figured out too about the Millennium Pipeline? Couldn't they use that to transport water as well? So that they didn't have to drive the trucks everywhere, or not as well, but you know, next door they could have two pipelines, or
They're probably hiring if you want to try to help them with that.
No, I said it's some genius idea. Okay,
try the next slide. And as I was mentioning, what the Department of Environmental Conservation is doing is known as the DSGEIS, Draft Supplemental Generic Environmental Impact Statement. And these are some of the deficiencies that are in this statement that we have seen, and many other organizations have also seen, and many individuals and communities have seen. One of the biggest ones, this is my favorite, and if any of you have been following what's going on in Albany right now, there's a terrible problem with the budget, and the Department of Environmental Conservation is getting cut more. They're losing more of its funds. So currently, there's not enough staff. What happens is, with this process, in order to drill, the gas company said, applies for the permit to the DEC. The DEC reviews the permit and then says, okay, permit approved, or they don't approve it. But anyway, they have a certain amount of staff to not only review the permits, but also to go out on site and look at the actual facilities to make sure that they're actually meeting the requirements of the permits. The DEC staff in the Department of Minerals, which is handling all this, I believe they're at 17 people. They're expecting, once this process goes through, they're expecting several thousand permit applications for 17 people to go through. And as I mentioned, 20,000, 25,000 wells for 17 people to be overseen. That's a major problem. Next slide, please. This is some of what's next as far as going forth with the state. As I said, the DEC is still looking at rules, but where now people are engaging with the legislature looking for improvements in New York State's laws. Like, there's not some laws that aren't in existence right now, or setbacks to keep people from drilling from closer to water bodies. There are setbacks that are in place that are good for the vertical wells, but now with this horizontal reach, you need to make further setbacks. So some legislation needs to come in play. And also some wastewater treatment. Next slide. That was, I borrowed Catherine's slides, but she's our main gas person. One of the areas that I didn't really touch upon was in the extraction process. At the pads themselves, in order to do the extraction, you have diesel generators running 24/7 to help power the whole thing. So not only do you have the diesel generators, you also have the trucks that come in. So there's also a tremendous amount of air pollution that goes along with this. In Texas, they're actually drilling in Fort Worth, which is a major city. And so the drilling is being done in Fort Worth, and they've done some air quality studies lately. And they've discovered that, by the way, let me just step back for a second. Fort Worth and Dallas are kind of like known as the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. So they're kind of connected cities. You know, it's kind of like New York and Hackensack, or Hoboken, if Hoboken was bigger. So they're kind of, that's kind of how they're set up. Now, from the drilling that's being done in Fort Worth, they've noticed that the amount of the air pollution, being ozone emissions, volatile organic compounds, and other emissions associated with burning a diesel fuel, it actually equates the amount of car and truck traffic that they currently have in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex area. So basically, it's an equivalent. From the gas drilling, you've created just as much air pollution as was already there from the truck and car traffic. So there's terrible air quality problems there as well. And actually, there's just one, I'll get to questions real quick. There's a small town in Texas called Dish, Texas, where they have processing facilities. After you extract the gas, it's not ready to be used in your homes. It has to go through a treatment for the process and processing in order to get rid of all the impurities, to vent out all the carbon dioxide that's in it. So basically, you want the clean methane, which is, as many of you probably know, is also a greenhouse gas that is actually 23 to 25% more potent than carbon dioxide.